can't sleep.
I was dreaming, Mom.
What about?
Bicycle.
Oh, that again, huh?
Dad, when can I get a bicycle?
I don't know. We'll see.
But you always say that.
Are you willing to earn it?
Yeah, I'll do anything.
Okay. You work really hard and save your money, and you can have a bicycle.
Thanks, Dad. Mom, do you need to take out the trash?
Not tonight, honey. It'll wait till the morning.
And that doll of yours is looking awfully tired. Why don't you take it on up to bed, okay?
Good job, Stace.
I've been saving all my money, like you said. I need to buy a kitten that Jody Wallace is selling for only 5 cents.
Well, I'm glad to hear that.
Dad, do you think I have enough money to buy a bike?
I think you've got enough to go look at one.
Right now?
This very second?
Oh, yes, please, please.
Well, I guess we could go
okay,
look at one.
On.
Hold it, hold it.
Hurry,
just a second. Well, let me step. Oh, okay.
Come on.
I will.
Come on.
Jess, you are going to go to the bike store. We'll be back in half an hour. Are you sure?
Yes.
That's a nice bike. Pink. God, it's really neat.
I'll never have enough to buy a bike, will I, Daddy?
Well, let's see how much money you have saved. You're not going to have enough. But I'll tell you what. You give me all that you have with a big hug and a kiss, and the bike is yours.
Really?
Really.
I love gymnastics. I remember when I was 12 years old, I saw the Olympics on television, and I knew that I wanted to be a gymnast. It was what I dreamed of, it's what I wanted to be. And it's exhilarating to feel the wind through your hair, to know that what you're doing is so beautiful and so flawless. I love the bars. Oh, man. I love to just think about those routines and do them in my mind just because it's so much fun. I love the bars because I liked the feeling of flying through the air and flipping. I was really in tune with the uneven parallel bars in that I could feel the exact spring and I could use every bit of momentum. My goal in gymnastics was to be an elite gymnast. All of my training was pushing toward that one goal. I got to stand on the victory stand, on the very top. It was the most thrilling experience of my life, and it taught me that if you stick it out and you don't give up, eventually you will succeed. The professional tour was a great way to finance my mission. I took a plane to Miami, Florida, and during the first day of practice, I was warming up on the vaulting horse. My spotter had to run across the gym to help somebody else, and so I decided I'd just do one more warm-up vault. I could do it by myself. I didn't need help of a spotter. But this time, I pushed way too hard off my hands, and unintentionally over-rotated a somersault, landed on the back of my neck. Right when I hit, I felt giant springs shooting right through my body, out through the tip of my toes. And I tried to call to somebody, but it was really difficult to speak. I couldn't get any air into my lungs. But soon people noticed that I was hurt. They called an ambulance, and they lift me on the stretcher, and I remember rolling out of the gym, just feeling I ruined everything. I knew right when I fell that I was hurt, but I didn't really realize how serious it was. I was pretty sure that within 3 months or so, I was gonna be back, and everything was gonna be all right. But as time went by, and as I got out of the hospital, I went home, and there I had to pick up my life. I remember sitting in front of a full-length mirror and looking at my reflection for the first time. And it was very frightening because I didn't look like a national champion gymnast. I looked like a stranger, and as I looked at my surroundings, there were trophies on the shelf, there were posters on the wall. All the days of my glory were behind me, and I hit rock bottom. I had nothing left to give, but deep down in my heart, I knew that Heavenly Father wouldn't leave me, and that if I just depended on Him and did my best, He'd be there. Sometimes life is hard, and it's not fair all the time. And sometimes you want things really bad, and they don't happen. And you pulled every ounce of courage and everything you've got out, and it's not enough. It's not that you want to give up, but you cannot give anymore. And I believe at that point that you can cast your burdens upon the Lord. And because He loves us so much, He's going to strengthen us. And you know, that doesn't always mean that some miracle is going to happen and everything's going to change. It's more like the miracle is the change inside of you. It's like He makes it so that all of a sudden you can cope and you can find happiness in life again. And you can go on even though everything is broken apart. You know, when I was a gymnast, it was, when I think about the resurrection, it didn't really mean very much to me because I couldn't think of very much that I wanted changed. But after my accident and landing in a wheelchair, it's going to be great. I can't wait for the Savior to come. I'm going to be first in line to be healed. I think I'll try a cartwheel or two.
The missionaries came to our class one day, and they gave us each a Book of Mormon. They asked us to put our testimonies in the front and give it to one of our friends. The book probably sat in my locker for a month. I was really afraid. I didn't know what to say. But there was Mark. So I offered a silent prayer, and I asked for courage to be able to just do it. And I stood up, and before I knew it, I handed it to him. I couldn't believe it. I was actually telling him about the Book of Mormon. I was acting like a missionary. He didn't say too much. He just kind of took the book and walked away. It was incredible. And I know without the Lord's help, I never would have been able to do it. I was there the first time Mark ever gave a prayer out loud. I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know if he'll be baptized. But if I hadn't have asked for strength that day, who knows when I would have shared the gospel with him.
I remember one day at school, I said something really rude to Diana about her clothes. It's really stupid. Sometimes I just can't believe the things I say and do just to impress my friends. I know it's not right. Oh, so I prayed. I prayed for strength to help me change and to do what I knew I had to do. The apology wasn't easy. But without the Lord's help, I never could have done it.